Hello, second year. Welcome to the next session for the online lectures. In the previous lectures, we have seen the different methods of tachymeter, in which we have seen the STADI. There are two methods. First one is the STADI method and second one is the tangential hair method. In STADI hair method, again there are two subtypes. One is the fixed hair method, second one is the movable hair method. So we have focused on what is fixed hair method. Okay. Now, again in that fixed hair method, there are three cases. First case is your line of collimation is completely horizontal, means vertical angle is 0, 0. Second case is line of collimation is inclined, maybe inclined upward or inclined downward. These are the three cases. Now, based on the fixed hair method, we may have some numericals. So, today in this video, we are going to solve one numerical based on the STADI hair method. Fixed hair method. Okay, so all of you please note down the particular observation table for the numerical. Okay, so let us start with the first instrument station. It is from May 2018. First column is instrument station. Second is height of instrument. Then next one is staff station. Then next is vertical angle. Then top, central and bottom crosshair readings. So first is top, second is center and bottom. So likewise, we have to prepare the columns. Instrument station is O. Height of instrument is 1.53. Staff stations. There are two staff stations, one is A, second is B. Then vertical angle for A, it was minus 15 degrees 20 minutes. Minus 15 degrees 20 minutes. Then three crosshair readings, top, center and bottom. Top is 2.45. Top is 2.45. Center is 1.98 and 1.51 is your bottom. I hope that second year, whatever I have written on the board, it is clearly visible. If it is not clearly visible, please let me know. Okay, so I will put a snapshot below the particular video. Okay, next, for the station, staff station B. The vertical angle they have given is as 0 degrees 0 minutes. Vertical angle 0 degrees 0 minutes, it stands for the line of collimation is completely horizontal. Then top, center and bottom crosshair readings 2.62, 2.62, 2.12 and 1.62. So this is the observation table, and they told us to find out the distance. Okay, one more information they had given us they have given us the RL of 0.0 as 150.500 meters, and the question is find out the distance OA, distance OB, and what is the RL of point A. These are the three quantities they have asked us. Okay, so let us start with the two cases. This is the first case. You can see where line of collimation is inclined, and this negative vertical angle shows line of collimation is inclined downward. Okay, so let us start from this case number one. Line of collimation is inclined downward. Okay, so I'm going to erase the whole thing and I'll try to draw the case number one, and this is the case number two. Okay, now from the case number one itself, we have to find out the distance OA as well as we have to find out the RL of point A. Now, as line of collimation is inclined downward, I will draw instrument station, say over here, and at lower elevation, I will draw the star station. Okay, say this line is nothing but my instrument axis. This is say instrument axis, and the line from this instrument towards this star will be the central hair reading, and two more lines will show you the top and the bottom gross hair readings. Okay, so I will name them as small a, small b, and small c. I will name the top, bottom, and sorry, top, middle, and bottom cross hair readings as small a, small b, and small c. Clear? Now, the RL of point O is 150.500.
150.500.
From the central crosshair reading B to the instrument axis, this is nothing but your vertical component V, and from the middle crosshair to the ground, this is nothing but your H. This is nothing but your H. Always keep in mind that for stadia method, from the middle hair or central hair reading to the horizontal line of sight, that is nothing but your vertical component V, and from central hair reading to the ground, that is your H. Okay, so please keep this thing in mind that we have to take V and H. The line of collimation may be inclined upward or it might be inclined downward. So this is line of collimation inclined downward with a vertical angle minus 15 degrees 20 minutes. Second year, minus 15 degrees 20 minutes. Okay, so let us start with the formula. We will start, first of all, write down the formula. D is equal to F upon I, the multiplying constant, multiplied by S, multiplied by cos square of theta, plus F plus D into cos of theta. Second year, please check the formula, whether the formula is correct. Yes, F upon I into S into cos square of theta plus F plus D into cos of theta. Always use this formula when your line of collimation is inclined, maybe upward or maybe downward. Okay, so here I will say this is our case number one. say this is case 1. So I will say this is D1, say this is S1. We are going to find out this distance from instrument station O to this station, star station A. This is star station A. Okay, so I would like to show you this distance D from instrument station to the star station. So this distance is D1. I hope you have understood this distance, the horizontal distance. Now I will write down the formula. D is equal to F upon I multiplying constant multiplied by S1 multiplied by cos square of theta plus F plus D into cos of theta. Whereas F upon I is multiplying constant, S1 is staff intercept, cos square of theta is nothing but your vertical angle, F plus D is your additive constant, cos of theta is your vertical angle. Here, F upon I will be equal to 100 and F plus D will be equal to 0, because instrument fitted with analytical lens if your instrument fitted with an analytical lens we will take F upon I as 100, F plus D is equal to 0. Okay, so let us first of all find out what is S1. S1 will be equal to the top pair reading minus bottom pair reading. What is top pair reading? Top pair reading is 2.45, bottom pair reading is 1.51. So 2.45 minus 1.51. So let us calculate the answer. Second year, my simultaneously 2.45 minus 1.51. It will be 0.94. It will be 0.94. Okay. So we have got all the values. So let us substitute those values to find out the distance D1. Okay. So I'll just try to erase this as I'm having very less space over here. F upon I, it is 100 because instrument is fitted with an analytical lens. S1 is 0.94, just now we have calculated. It is nothing but the difference between top hair reading minus bottom hair reading, cos square of cos 15 degrees 20 minutes plus F plus D is 0. So remaining all the terms will become 0. So yes, second year, please tell me the calculate 100 multiplied by 0.94 multiplied by cos 15 degrees 20 minutes square. Let us calculate it. Cos 15 degrees, first of all we will calculate angle, square of the angle multiplied by 0.94 multiplied by 100. So it is 87.427. D1 is 87.427. This is your first answer. So try to highlight this answer. Always try to highlight your final answer. Okay? So this is our first answer. Let us go towards the second answer, which is nothing but to find out the RL of a point A. For RL of point A, we require one more quantity. The second quantity is to find out the vertical component V. The formula for vertical component V is equal to F upon I multiplied by S into sine 2 theta upon 2 plus f plus d into sin theta. This is the formula to calculate vertical component v.
Where we require vertical component? Let us see. Now, as we require to find out the RL of point A, if we are doing the instrument axis RL, from instrument axis RL, we have to deduct this much of height. This consists of V and H. So, instrument axis RL. Shall I use this part, second year? I will use this part to write down the statement. RL of point A. RL of point A will be equal to instrument axis RL minus V minus H. Because if we know the instrument axis RL, from instrument axis RL minus deduct V deduct H, you will reach at point A. Okay. So for this thing we require V. Okay. So let us calculate V. V will be equal to F upon I, which is 100 multiplied by S1. S1 is 0.94 multiplied by sine of twice of angle 15 degrees 20 minutes divided by 2. Let us calculate the answer. First, only calculate this sine of twice of 15 degrees 20 minutes. It will be 30 degrees and 40 minutes divided by 2 multiplied by 0.84 multiplied by 100. So you will get 23.972, which is 23.972. Next, what is the instrument axis RL second year? Instrument axis RL is nothing but the RL of point O plus HI. HI is 1.53. So this is 150.5 plus 1.53. So it will be instrument axis RL is 150.5 plus 1.53. 152.03. 152.03. Okay, second year, please check. Now, I will substitute this value. 152.03 minus V. V is, we have calculated it at 23.972 minus H. What is H? H is nothing but this height. Means at point B. B is nothing but your center air reading. So what is it? It was something 1.98. So let us calculate 152.03 minus 23.972 minus 1.98. So it is 126. It is 126.078. Students, RL of point A is 126.078. Please check what I have done. I have just calculated the RL of point A by using the formula instrument axis RL minus V minus H. Why minus V minus H? Because here we have got this value 152.03, from which we have to deduct this much of height. We have to deduct, if I extend this line, we have to deduct this much of height, then we will reach at a result of RL of point A. So where we should find out V as well as we have to find out H. Okay, to find out V, we are doing a formula F upon I into sine 2 theta upon 2 into S plus F plus D into sine of theta, where F upon I and F plus D are the constants of a tachymeter. 100 and 0 is nothing but your value. So substitute it. S1 is, we have found out, which is 0.94, top hair reading minus bottom hair reading,
and sine of y sub angle, angle is vertical angle, 15 degrees and 20 minutes. Okay, so calculated value is 23.97. Substitute it over here and you will get the required argument point E. Second year, we have finished with the two answers. So case A or case 1 is completed. Remaining is we have to find out the distance O to B. If any doubts in case 1 or case 2, you can comment in the comment box. I will try to solve all of your queries as early as possible. Here, if you look at the observation table, for point B, the vertical angle is 0,0. When vertical angle is 0,0, what does this mean? This is nothing but your line of communication completely horizontal. So, we will draw case 1. In case 1, instrument and the object or staff is at the same level. This is the bottom crosshair reading. Say this is the top crosshair reading. Small a, small b, small c. This is instrument station O. This is instrument station, staff station B. We would like to find out this distance D2. This is your case number 2. Vertical angle is 0,0. So it is straightforward formula. Formula is D is equal to F upon I into S2 plus F plus D. Here, as it is vertical angle 0,0, there won't be any kind of sine or cos or anything. Okay. So put the values. What is F upon I? It is 100. What is S2 students? We have to find out S2. S2 will be equal to top crosshair reading minus bottom crosshair reading. It is 2.62 minus 1.62. 2.62 minus 1.62. So it is, obviously it is 1.00. So substitute S2 into the formula. F upon I, we have to take it as 100. As instrument is fitted with an analytical lens, multiplied by 1.00 plus 0. So D2 will be equal to 100. So students, we have found the third answer. So likewise, we have completed the numerical. We have found the first answer, which is distance O to A. Then we have found out the distance. Then we have found out the RL of point A. Then at the end, we have found out the RL of point, the distance D2. I hope that you have understood this numerical. If you understood, please comment in the comment box. Otherwise, I would like to make one more lecture on the combination of elevation angle as well as depression angle. Okay, students. So here I will be concluding this video with the statement that in the exams, this numerical will be either for 7 to 8 marks. So you will get good marks if you solve it correctly. As compared with the theory, you will get all the marks if we have all the results correct. Okay, students. So thank you very much, students. Stay home and stay safe.